Hey, hello. You know what I forgot to do? Here, let me. I just need to do a real quick promotional thing. There you go. Bam. Facebooked. Facebooked again, and then tweeted. All right. Awesome. I need to pull up the chat, and then I'm doing a little. Uh-oh. No. No. All
Fucked.
right. I'm doing a little experiment today. So I have heretofore over these past few months since I started doing this, whenever I would drink booze while playing, the show would fall apart. But I'm hoping that because I really want a beer, and so I had a, I am ha I have a beer. Here's my beer. It's I'm not I don't think am I allowed to show what it is? So I don't think so. I think that unless they pay me lots of sponsorship dollars, I can't show you what beer it is. Although you guys know what it is, it's still. I'm gonna drink beers throughout the show. And maybe, and maybe it'll work and maybe it won't. And we'll see. This will be the experiment. But my voice is ruined, of course, because I sang for 4 hours yesterday, and then I went to bowling. And I bowled, and I was bowling, and I screamed just to be heard over the sound of bowling balls and pins crashing and people talking, and then I literally got 4 hours of sleep, and then I got up and I went to work, and I worked all day, and then I yeah, and then I and I was screaming at people at work, and so my voice is really rough, and I'm drinking beer. And so we'll see how the show goes. I think it's gonna be. I think all I'm saying is I think this is a recipe for awesome. I think this is gonna be like one of those seminal moments that will go down in history. I think by the time I die, there will be billions of views of this actual video. That's all I'm saying. That's just what I'm guessing. All right. So let me think. Let me just. I'm just gonna. I'm gonna just kind of slowly work my way into this show. She bled on the mattress the first night at my studio. I panicked, but she said, "Baby, don't you know?" The blood's much thicker than water. I nodded, but I don't think it got her. 3 weeks later, she moved into my studio. All she brought was a stereo, a broken stereo, and a picture of me that she put at her bedside. I'm a ledger, she's a cheater. I let her cut me, she likes to let me beat her. I'm a fucker, she's a screamer. I may be tougher, but she's definitely all of our love, with all of the spite, we go to the mattress. With all of our love, with all of the spite, we go to the mattress. As I slept, she burned me, so I broke her collarbone. She ran to the neighbors, but he wasn't home. So she hitched to the clinic, but they wouldn't accept her, so she come to get her. Love, she said, is a force that draws me to you. I said, sugar, I want to believe that's true. She said, lover, you can trust me forever, cause we're just getting better. I'm a lecher, she's a cheater. I let her cut me, she likes to let me beat her. I'm a fucker, she's a screamer. I may be tougher, but she's definitely meaner. With all of my love, with all of the spite, we go to the mattress. With all of our love, with all of the spite, we go to the mattress. Hey, Mary. I never knew she could be so cruel. I never knew she could seem so beautiful to me. I never meant to hurt her at all. Push came to shove and she was falling down. I'm a lecher. her, she's a cheater. I let her cuddle, she likes to let me beat her. I'm a fucker, she's a screamer. I may be tougher, but she's definitely meaner. With all of our love, with all of our spite, we go to the mattress. With all of our love, with all of our spite, we go to the mattress.
All right, let me just do some adjusting of the. So, no, I'm gonna go this way. Is that better? Yes, that's better. There we go. Okay, cool. So now the guitar can be seen a little bit better. Hey, Blank, good to see you, man. How you doing, amigo? How are you, Mary? Good to see you. Thanks for being here. So yeah, I'm not certain if you guys know, but I have a, we lost, our gas was turned off accidentally. It's not like we couldn't afford to pay it. We didn't realize that we put all the utilities in my name because what was happening was Katie was paying the utilities and not telling me how much I owed, and then she would let me know, like I would find, I'd be like, hey, I need to pay you your utilities, and she'd be like, oh yeah, I'll get you that number at some point. And it would go for months. And then by the time I went to pay her, I owed like $600 or $800. And I'm like, I don't have that kind of money. So we put them in my name because that way I could just reach out to her. And so every single time, you know, but anyway, but we forgot to put the gas bill in my name. So we thought all the bills were in my name. The gas bill wasn't. Our gas got turned off, but we're sorting it out. Are you a long day? Yeah, this is today for me. I mean, by the time Friday rolls around, it's been a pretty long day, but or a pretty long week. But all right, I'm just gonna play stuff that strikes my fancy for a little while. You know what? I'm gonna play "Tapeworm Love." I like this song. So this is a song that I just kind of rediscovered maybe a week ago, and I just hadn't played it. I hadn't even listened to it. I didn't know what it sounded like, and I'm like "Tapeworm of Love, that sounds cool. What is that?" And I listened to it, and I'm like, this is a great song. Hold on. And so now I'm playing it because I really like it. So I added a couple more sounds to the soundboard just to get up to 200. But it looks like, so if I get up to, you know, but when I get up to 1,000 followers, which looks like I'll hit next week, then at that point in time, the soundboard, the soundboard sounds will still be there. I'm just going to pull off all the commands on the Get Set Go Bot. I'm just going to have like 20 commands. So just letting you know, if you want to know what those commands are, you should come here now and copy and paste them, put them in a little file you can keep on your desktop. That's the way I do it. That's the way I do things. I know that we've been around, but I don't want to get you down. I only want you to smile. But the devil, he gets into me, and suddenly all I see is nothing but wide open miles. Oh, I've run to exhaustion, there's nowhere for me to go. I'm done with running, darling, don't you know? Oh, lover, I am stuck on you, like bubble gum gets stuck on shoes. I'm in your hair and never climbing out. Oh, lover, I am into you, like subway trains that pull into the station when you desperately need one. Oh, I'm in love. Oh, I'm in love with you. Oh, I'm in love. Oh, I'm in love with you. Every morning we get up together, we're just enough to kick ass and take all the names. Cause waking up next to you is all I really wanna do. Darling, do you feel the same? Oh, I feel that you're in me. Like a tapeworm made of love. And for that tapeworm, I thank God above. Hey, Anton! Oh, lover, I am stuck on you. Like bubblegum gets stuck on shoes. I'm in your hair and never climbing out. Oh, lover, I am into you. Like subway trains that pull into the station when you desperately need one. Oh, I'm in love. Oh, I'm in love with you. Oh, I'm in love. Oh, I'm in love with you. Tapeworm of love. Tapeworm of love for me and you. Tapeworm of love. Tapeworm of love for me and you. What do you mean? What do you mean? Did you catch Edgewalker? Are you asking that was that song that I just played, Edgewalker? Because if you're asking that, then no, that's not Edgewalker. That's a completely different song. But are you asking, will I play Edgewalker? Oh, yeah, you want to do it? All right, so I'm thinking, in fact, it's Friday, I just don't care. What? Yeah, let's do it. Let's do Edgewalker. Rules are made to be broken. They're specifically designed to be broken. Anytime someone gives you a rule, You're automatically obligated to just immediately break it. here we go. So this is a sing-along. Your part's gonna be, let's take a walk out to the edge. Let's dangle from the precipice till our last breath. Let's take a walk to the edge. Let's dangle from the precipice till our last breath. So that's gonna be your part, right? And basically where you really need to sing it, it's gonna come up twice before you absolutely have to sing it. The reason why you absolutely have to sing it is because the entire outro, the very ending of the song, it's just counterpointing vocal melodies, right? So while you're singing that, let's take a walk to the edge. Let's dangle from the precipice till our last breath. I'm gonna be singing, oh, you know that it will be alright. You know we'll feel alright so very soon. And they're gonna lay over each other, and it's gonna be awesome. So you have to sing, otherwise, you know, the song is not nearly as awesome as it could be. Here we go. You know we'll feel alright so very soon. Oh, you know that it will be okay. Just let it slip away. What can we do? Let's take a walk to the edge. Let's dangle from the precipice till our last breath. Let's take a walk to the edge. Let's dangle from the precipice till our last breath. Oh, you know that it will be alright. You know we'll feel alright so very soon. Oh, you know that it will be okay. Just let it slip away. What can we do? Oh, you know that we are getting older, but we are getting better looking. Close your eyes, another new surprise, another something wicked is a cooking. You know that it will be just fine. You know it's just your mind that you can steal. you know that when it's broken down, we make the newest sounds and then we kill. Let's take a walk out to the edge. Let's dangle from the precipice till our last breath. Let's take a walk out to the edge. Let's dangle from the precipice till our last breath. Oh, you know that it will be just fine. You know it's just your mind that you can steal. Oh, you know that when it's broken down, we make the newest sounds and then we kill. Oh, you know that we are getting older, but we are getting better looking. Close your eyes, another new surprise, another something wicked is a cooking. Hey, Jared. Oh, you know that it will be alright. You know we'll feel alright so very soon. Oh, you know that it will be okay. Just let it slip away. What can we do? Here we go. Let's take a walk up to the edge. Let's dangle from the precipice till our last breath. Let's take a walk. Keep this going. Up to the edge. Let's dangle from the precipice till our last breath. Oh, you know that it will be alright. You know we'll feel alright so very soon. Oh, you know that it will be okay. Just let it slip away. What can we do? Oh, you know that it will be alright. You know we'll feel alright so very soon. Keep it going. Oh, you know that it will be okay. Just let it slip away. What can we do? Let's take a walk out to the edge. Let's dangle from the precipice till our last breath. Let's take a walk out to the edge. Let's dangle from the precipice till our last breath. Let's take a walk. Yeah, we lost poor Steve in a terrible edge walking accident. Alas. Hey, Lenina, right on. The thing I think that anything that keeps people listening to music is a good thing, right? The thing is people, like, at some point in time, like, this is what I feel this way about all musicians, right? Like, we're all in each other's corners. And really truthfully, it's kind of like if you're a poor person, then attacking if you're a poor black person, then attacking a poor white person, that's exactly what they want you to do. You know, the thing is they want us to be divided. Same thing with musicians. The thing is that if you listen to, if you're someone that really likes rap, right? And any genre of rap, if you really like rap, at some point in time, you might say, you know what? I think I'm kind of tired of rap. I think I want to go find something new. And that person who has continued to listen to music this entire time now goes off and seeks something else out. And maybe they find my band. And maybe they go, man, this guy's great. And maybe that opens up a whole new world for them. Maybe they find some other band. But the thing is as long as people are listening to music, the real heartbreak for me is when people stop listening to music. And that does happen. I definitely have friends now in their mid 30s and early 40s and wherever, you know, like that their music taste calcified. They basically had the bands they listened to when they were a kid. Those are the bands they like, and that's it, you know. I don't ever disparage other musicians. Musicians keep people listening to music, and that's always a good thing. I'm gonna play some songs I haven't played in a while, like that one that I just started.
Oh, you've been also very cold. I don't know why you've been so damn cold. I wanna talk to you. but you won't talk to me. I wonder, should I leave? Things have changed, haven't they, my friend? Nothing stays the same, it all changes in the end. But can we just pretend? Let us just pretend that you still love me. Oh, America, do you still love me? Oh, America, do you still love me? Oh, we used to be the very best of friends. The futures were so bright way back then. We could do most anything, anything at all. Where did we go wrong? Oh, America, do you still love me? Oh, America, do you still love me? We're not as young as we used to be, and the things that we learned, we didn't learn for free. It all came at a cost, such a heavy cost. But do you still love me? Oh, America, do you still love me? Oh, America, do you still love me? Oh, America, did you ever love me?
Oh, that was kind of rough. Here, I'll play Child of God on the ukulele. It's going all right. I mean, I don't think I've yet played it. I don't think I've yet played it flawlessly all the way through. So, hey, thank you, Jared. Thank you, man. So I still have to look at the fretboard to make sure I got the relationship of my fingers and the chords, the chord shapes are. You know, we've talked about this on occasion on the show. So I haven't really listened to popular music. I was part of an East Side LA indie rock scene that started out in 1998, and there were about 200 bands in orbit around our little night. There was a nightclub called Mr. T's Bowl where this little scene was kind of happening. There's actually a really great movie about it. Well, the first part of the movie is actually about our scene. And then there's another scene, another adjunct scene that actually got a lot bigger, at least in the Los Angeles area, that the movie's is ultimately about. But our little community kicks it off, and I think you can definitely find it on Amazon. You might be able to find it on Netflix. It's a movie called In Heaven There Is No Beer, and so the thing is, I literally had hundreds of bands that were friends of mine that I could listen to for years and years. So
I know what I'm doing.
Hammer. Yeah, and that's so So yeah, the thing is, I don't know John Mayer at all, and the thing is that like, but and so if you want to turn me on, if you want to suggest maybe a handful of songs that are favorites of yours, I definitely would check them out at some point in time. The thing is that. I say that my time is always exceptionally valuable to me because I do this basically right now I'm working about 60 hours a week. And then that's on top of anything else that I do, so the thing is like, so if you have like maybe one or two songs that you're like, hey, you should definitely check these out. These are representative of his stuff. I know that I can't get a full perspective on somebody with just two songs. That's ridiculous. But at least it might be able to give me a little bit of a primer. That would be awesome. But anyway, here we go. So hey, and good to see you, Bandit. Yeah, and Lenina, yeah, that's like, yeah, I mean, those albums were like the sort of my foundation, but there are so many. I mean, I've always been a huge music fan. That's really funny. Like as people were listing off, like Jesus and Mary Chain, that particularly that the album Automatic, like that album fucking ruled my world and really was the foundation upon which where I'm like, when I started figuring out their songs, I'm like, oh shit, this is easy stuff. I can do this. And so, yeah. So anyway, but here we go. So this is Child of God on the ukulele. Once when I was a boy of about 9 or 10, I fell in love with the girl who lived next door. Oh, and every day after school, she would wait by a fence, and we would play till her parents got home, and she would sing this song. It still gives me shivers. Mommy doesn't love me and Daddy doesn't want me, but I'm a child of God. Mommy doesn't love me and Daddy doesn't want me, but I'm a child of God. While we sat in his lap, and he made us sing the song that she sang, the song, the song that is still here every day. He used to stroke her face while she sang this song. Mommy doesn't love me and Daddy doesn't want me, but I'm a child of God. Mommy doesn't love me and Daddy doesn't want me, but I'm a child of God. One autumn day, she asked me to wait. She asked me to meet her at the top of the hill. And so I went, hoping to spend some time with the girl that I loved. But she never showed. No, she never arrived. For this was the day that she died. Ooh. every day for a year. As we lived in that house, I would hear her singing in the middle of the night. And I know that I should have been very afraid, but I love the sound of her voice. And she would sing to me. Now I've been set free. Here's my song I sing for you.
You're excited. Feel these nipples.
Mommy doesn't love me and daddy doesn't want me, but I'm a child of God. Mommy doesn't love me and daddy doesn't want me, but I'm a child of God. Mommy doesn't love me, daddy doesn't want me. Mommy doesn't love me, daddy doesn't want me. So something like that. It's still like, you know, like, it's just whenever I look away from the fretboard, I like, because I'm just not comfortable. I'm not used to having like playing chords so nice and tight like that. That's what she said. It basically really freaks me out. You know, like, and so I need to keep playing and building the relationship with the ukulele, so I don't have to worry about where the chords go. And then of course, whenever I pick up a new instrument, like, I just cram, like, I just smash my fingers, like, oh, and so it also really hurts. So, but anyway, hey, good to see you, Edgemon. And okay, I will thank you, Reds. I will here, let me 10 albums. What's 10 albums? Oh yeah. I know, man. Yeah, I mean the thing is it, let me see. So I'm gonna record these songs. Neon and Stop the Train. Stop this train. Cool. Yeah. All right. Thanks, man. I'll definitely check those out when I get a chance. I'll definitely check it out over this weekend. So this weekend, Katie and I are going to her dad's place. Her dad and her stepmom, and we're gonna be doing our Christmas, like our kind of belated Christmas with that side of the family. But I'll have a little bit more free time than I normally would, which will be nice. But Jared, so real quick, so Jared, thank you so much, man. You are a gentleman and a scholar, and you're always very generous, and seriously, man, thank you so much. It is definitely very welcome, and I hope that you get your money's worth. The idea by keeping it to 10 is that you don't spend a lot of time thinking about it, right? You just think back to that time and you put down the albums that just kind of pop out of your head, like, cuz the thing is, cuz there are like the Descendants' Livage. I totally forgot that one. I couldn't believe I forgot that one. There's so many, but the thing is I just went with the first 10 that kind of popped into my head. They didn't define my life, but it's really funny because people were like, dude, when I checked out these albums, I'm like, that's crazy. Like, that makes so much sense, you know? Hey, Shamrock, right on, man. Good to see you. Okay. Yeah. See Nine Inch Nails. See, yeah, that's. I came to Tool very late, but I really dig those guys. So I'm gonna do, even though I don't want to start the main show until 7 o'clock because people kind of show up. I know a lot of people show up at 7. So the thing is it, but I'll play whatever you guys want to play. Want me to hear? Yeah. Well, the thing is, like, in fact, who's next? Who's next? I was 19 when I bought. I actually bought Who's Next. I had a friend of mine gave me a record player. I had no records. So I went up to a thrift store and I bought a bunch of records. And the first record I knew that the Who were good. I just hadn't ever experienced them. And I put on Bob O'Reilly. I put on Who's Next, which starts with Bob O'Reilly, you know, and that synthesizer. And I literally was fucking floored. Like that album just boggled my mind. Boggled my mind. Okay, so what am I gonna do? My first album, the first albums I ever bought, I bought four records. I was in sixth grade, I think, and it was I could have been seventh grade. It was the Dirty Dancing soundtrack, Whitesnake, the Whitesnake album with all their hits, Tiffany, and I forget that. Oh, and the Pet Shop Boys. So I bought those four. The Pet Shop Boys, like big hit album. And then literally within 3 months, a friend of mine turned me on to the Beatles, and that blew my mind. And then within a month or two of that, another friend of mine turned me on to the Violent Femmes, and it was like, and then it was just I was all over it. And like it was like I went down that rabbit hole. And then the Ramones and yeah. Oingo Boingo and Weird Al, and yeah, it was pretty awesome. Okay, okay, well, yeah, what do you guys want me to play? I don't know what I want to play. Let's do this.
Going places no one else has ever been to. There's no end to the trouble I get into, and I'm with you. I'm three steps ahead of all my sorrow, but I promise by tomorrow I'll repay you all the things that I have borrowed. I'm speeding past sunrise, racing through midnight. I try to slow it down, I'll come around. Never gonna lose, I'm a race car driver, the sole survivor, pedals to the metal as I make my getaway. Never gonna lose, I'm a race car driver, the sole survivor, pedals to the metal as I make my getaway. Impact that I know someday must come. I've been on the run, moving faster than a freight train. No one can catch me and they daren't even try, cause it's just too fast a guy. I'm alone on the highway, speeding past sunrise, racing through midnight. I try to slow it down, I come around. Gonna lose, I'm a race car driver, the sole survivor, pedals to the metal as I make my getaway. Never gonna lose, I'm a race car driver, the sole survivor, pedals to the metal as I make my getaway. Speeding getaway, speeding getaway, keep this going. Speeding getaway, speeding getaway. Someday I promise to surrender. Someplace, somewhere out there is better. Speeding getaway, speeding getaway, speeding getaway, speeding getaway. Someday I promise to surrender. Someplace, somewhere out there is better. Never gonna lose, I'm a race car driver, the sole survivor, pedals to the metal as I make my getaway. I'm never gonna lose, I'm a race car driver, the sole survivor, pedals to the metal as I make my getaway. The pedals to the metal as I make my getaway.
So what, okay, what it, yeah. So yeah. So what do you guys want to? So I don't. The thing is, one thing I was thinking this, right? So maybe why don't I play songs for a while? But my voice might at some point might give out, right? If my voice does give out because it's been a long week, and the Thursday into Friday night is just it's a real shitstorm for me. It just really taxes my voice because I'm always doing something where I'm kind of screaming. I was thinking that if my voice kind of gives out, then why don't we write a song? Why don't we write a song? We'll collaborate on a song. It won't be like the ones that we did. We won't belabor it. We'll just make it fun and silly and do it real. It'll be a real simple, like 1-4-5 kind of like just fun and easy and breezy. And we'll get it down. And then I'll work on it over the weekend and I'll get it out to you guys, you know, Monday or something. So that's my thinking. So you know, what do you guys think? Let me see. What do I want to play? Hey, Josh.
Setting myself on fire to read by the light. Nothing burns quite like me in the dark of night. Would you like to set yourself alight, baby? Would you like to glow? Does it hurt? No, certainly. But you will burn so bright. You will be a star in the sky. You will burn so bright.
Ah, sorry, Mary. But you're gonna have a good time with your friends, right?
Setting myself on fire to drive away the dark. Nothing burns so bright as a fire in my heart. Would you like to set yourself alight, baby? Would you like to glow? Does it hurt? No, certainly. But you so bright, you will be a star in the sky. You will burn so bright. Do you need a little light? 'Cause I can be the one, oh, to cast you to the sun, oh, and set your soul alight. Myself on fire to burn away the chill, 'cause the chill it burns much worse than the fire ever will. Would you like to set yourself alight, baby? Would you like to glow? Does it hurt? No, certainly. But you will burn so bright. You will be star in the sky. You will burn so bright. Do you need a little light? 'Cause I can be the one, oh, to cast you to the sun, oh, and set your soul alight.
I have no idea what happened there.
Oh, and you'll burn throughout the night.
Three quarters of a beer in and already I'm like, I'm just train wrecking songs. All right. Let me see. Yeah, I was thinking maybe I'd try to play some songs that I haven't played in a while that are good tunes.
climb. Peter lost another dodger. Peter lost another job today. He showed up drunk and 40 minutes late. It was Slap's mistake. Peter drank all through the day. Another drink to numb away the pain. But the day remained. Hey, hey, hey. Another ordinary day. Hey, hey, hey. Another ordinary day. In an ordinary world. With ordinary boys. Fucking ordinary girls. In an ordinary time. So ordinary that we are losing our minds. So what you gonna do? The choice is up to you. Mary got knocked up again. She got drunk and slept with her best friend. Because she knew that her best friend was gay. She fucked him anyway. Hey, hey, hey. Another ordinary day. Hey, hey, hey. Another ordinary day. In an ordinary world. With ordinary boys. Fucking ordinary girls. In an ordinary time. So ordinary that we are losing our minds. So what you gonna do? The choice is up to you. Into his car, filled up the tank, and fled to foreign parts. With a broken heart, Mary is a single mom. She loves her son, but laments the life she lost. She bears a heavy cross. Hey, hey, hey. Another ordinary day. Hey, hey, hey. Another ordinary day. In an ordinary world. With ordinary boys. Fucking ordinary girls. In an ordinary time. So ordinary that we are losing our minds. So what you gonna do? The choice is up to you.
Hey, Gamers for God, good to see you. Awesome, right on. Thank you for being here. I was thinking, would you guys maybe another thing that we could do, right? Maybe another thing that we could do is I could just improv songs. I could just spend a whole evening just writing like improvising silliness. Just because the thing is that, like, I kind of feel like I haven't really written much over the past handful of months, and I literally feel like every single time I sit down and just do anything.
La-da-dum-dum-ba-da-da-dum-ba-dum-ba-da-da-dum-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-d
You know, it's like melodies are just, and I'm like, I gotta do something with these. So anyway, I'm just letting you guys know. I'm just saying, like, you know, but I don't know about right now, but I'm just saying, you know, like, at some point in time, we'll have to do something like that. Okay. So the show's about to start in about 10 minutes. I'm gonna have to use the facilities before I actually do the show, because I drank a ton of water in the hopes that it would repair my voice in advance of the show. So let me do another one, and then I'm gonna hit the lavatory, and then we'll get the show up and running, and that's when she hit me. In fact, I used to have a. I just want to punch you. It was basically, you know, that movie, you know, the movie Punch Drunk Love. There's a moment where you're feeling so much emotion that Punch Drunk Love is a great example of this, right? So there's this moment where it's like when you have something really cute, right? You have this like a brand new kitten. You just love it so much. You just want to crush the life out of it. I love you so much. And it's that same kind of thing when you have this like intense emotion. And so I don't know if you guys remember Punch Drunk Love, but they're like Adam Sandler and I forget the actress's name, but they're sort of like laying on top of each other, and he's like, I love you so much, I just want to take a sledgehammer to your face, you know, and then she kind of retorts with something, you know, something equally as brutal and vicious, but it's such a cool and loving, you know, loving scene. And so I wrote a song called Pugilism in the Face of Love that. I haven't played it in forever, but okay, Edgymon. All right, no worries, brother. Get some rest, man. Right on. You have a great evening. Thanks for being a part of this. It's good to have you back, man. And get some rest. Okay. All right. So yeah, let me see. What do I want to play? I haven't played this one in a while.
Should I find my house all up in flames, I would simply light a cigarette and watch it burn away. And should I find that all my money's gone, I would empty out my pockets and give it to someone. Ain't nothing gonna get me down, 'cause I'm in love. How I lived for her, I don't know. Oh, I must have been so miserable, I wonder if it showed. But now she's here and I feel like you got. I can smite the evildoers and make right of every wrong. Ain't nothing gonna get me down, 'cause I'm in love. Oh, joyous day, don't you ever take yourself away. Just give me a little bit more time. Oh, let us stay together under any sort of weather. Let me love her like I love her, like she loves me, like we love one another. Oh, I'm hoping for a real long night. Should I learn that no one likes my songs, I would sing for no one other than the lover I'm writing for. And should I find myself attacked by bears? Well, if I'm attacked by bears, I'm gonna have to run, because bears are scary and they eat faces. But I would run much faster, because I know what I am after. Ain't nothing gonna get me down, because I'm in love. Oh, joyous day. Don't you ever end, don't take yourself away. Just give me a little bit more time. Oh, let us stay together.
together under any sort of weather. Let me love her like I love her, like she loves me, like we love one another. Oh, I'm hoping for a real long night.
Here we go. This is a whistle along part.
For a real long night.
Okay, I'm gonna hit the lavatory real quick. I'm gonna be right back here. I actually even made something. Here we go. So I'm gonna put on a song real quick. And then as soon as we get back, we'll get the show up and running. Can you guys sort out what you want to do for the sing along? I would love it if you could. Okay, here we go. I'll be back in a second.
We like beer and we like booze, and we don't follow any rules, and we don't like you, we don't like them, we don't like the things that happen. Oh, let's go have fun. We're so tired of working late. We want to find a new escape. Oh, we're so sick of being here. We wish we could just disappear. We like beer and we like booze, and we don't follow any rules, and we don't like them, we don't like them, we don't like the things that happen. Oh, let's go have fun.
Wait, give me, all right. Give me one second, all right. All right, sorry about that. Okay, here. So, all right, what are we gonna do for, what do we wanna do for a sing-along? Hold on, let me take a look and see if there's any consensus. Do you guys sort anything? Cannibalism, I hate everyone, cannibalism is a cure. Okay, yeah. Sure, I can do that. Awesome. Shall we do cannibalism to start the show, or shall we do I Hate Everyone? What do you guys think? Let's do I Hate Everyone as the sing along. So, or as the opening sing along. Let me do this. I'm gonna mute myself just for a second.